Hi everyone, and welcome to this quick video about our new TV reference app. I'm Ian Clifton, and I work on the developer relations team at Google. With Google TV, both app quality and app integrations are more important than ever. We've done a lot of work to update our documentation, but we know many developers learn best when they can just look at an actual implementation and start taking it apart. With that in mind, we've built a completely new reference app. The reference app is available today in our public GitHub repository, so you can go to github.com/android/tv-samples and check it out. It's written in Kotlin, so not surprisingly, the directory is reference app Kotlin. Hopefully also not surprising is that we've included a detailed README that covers the various integrations and some of our thought process behind how we implemented them. Don't worry, I won't read the whole file now. Instead, we're going to do an overview of the reference app. Here's an Android TV device that has the reference app installed. This device is not running the Google TV experience so that I can easily show you the home screen channel that the app creates. This home screen channel is created when the system sends the initialized program's broadcast, which you can send directly to the receiver via ADB, and I'll give more details about that in a bit. The app just creates a single channel and picks content at random to populate it. Selecting a tile here goes into playback, but let's launch the app via the banner. When launched via the banner, you will see this warning screen that basically tells you Firebase is not configured. You can still access the videos and most of the features, but some Firebase-dependent functionality is not enabled. For example, the sample includes code support for Google account linking, but that requires you to set up a Firebase instance. We have a lot of details in the README, so let's continue on to the next screen. This is the main browse screen where we have the video split into rows using a browse support fragment. We have two rows of clips, which are developer relations videos. Then we have one row for Beverly Hillbillies and one for movies with Charlie Chaplin. I will select one of the movies to start playback. Playback uses a video support fragment to handle the bulk of the UI. We have a very simple state machine to communicate events like pause to the different pieces of code that care about them. The actual playback is handled via ExoPlayer, and it includes support for media session via media session connector. The media session integration allows for controlling playback with remote control, Bluetooth headset, or even voice. You can press the assistant and say, skip forward 5 minutes. And it skips forward 5 minutes. It also supports all kinds of other commands that you'd expect, like pause and play, and even asking what's currently playing. I'll completely back out of the app now to show one more thing. Back on the Android TV home screen, there's a feature called Watch Next. This feature can be labeled as Play Next or Continue Watching, depending on the version, but the idea is the same. This lets users quickly jump back into the content they were previously watching. For example, you can see the Charlie Chaplin movie we're watching shows up here. This feature also works for TV episodes, but it should not be used with clips, which is why we've organized the video content in the app the way that we have. If I select content from Keep Watching, it deep links directly into playback right where the user left off. And if I press back, it returns to the main browse screen. That's pretty much it from the app experience side of things, so let's take a quick look at the source code. Features are organized into packages. For example, if you want to see all the code related to home screen channels, all the relevant files are in the home screen channels package. There are some files that don't really belong to a feature, such as the data models, so those are under the shared package. You might also notice there's a package for Cast Connect, which I didn't demonstrate. Cast Connect allows an Android TV app to act as a cast receiver. So you can trigger playback from another device, such as a phone, but it's actually the Android TV app that's playing the content. We have a specific README for Cast Connect in the repository that goes over the feature in much more detail and also walks through the steps of creating a sender so that you can use the reference app as a receiver. I want to highlight just a few things in the source code. First, in the resources directory, we have a raw JSON file that tells the app about all the metadata for our videos. It's nicely formatted, so you can easily modify it yourself in case you want to test something out. We also included a scripts folder that has an ATV CSV to JSON script, Python script. So you can always provide your own CSV if you want to bulk change all of this data. I mentioned home screen channels earlier. That package contains the receiver that triggers the initial building of the channel. You can look at that file or the main README file to see the exact ADB command you use to trigger the receiver. The receiver only exists to get that broadcast and tell the work manager about new work to do. The worker contains the high-level code, like if a channel doesn't exist, create one. The helper contains all the lower-level logic, like how to query for which programs have been added to a given home screen channel. The watch next code follows a similar pattern of a worker with high-level code and a helper with low-level details. One difference is that the watch next code is triggered by a listener, which brings us to playback. Playback has more files in it, but the important ones are playback fragment, playback view model, and playback state machine. Starting with the state machine, it defines a simple interface to receive state changes and a sealed class that has all the states like load, prepare, play, etc. The view model provides an implementation of the state machine that uses a list of playback state listeners and informs them of the changes. State machines can get complicated, so we also created a state machine README that has more details. The overall idea is that different parts of unrelated code care about the states. For example, the watch next listener wants to know when playback is paused or ends, so it can update the watch next row using the worker I mentioned. There's also a completely separate watch progress listener that cares about similar events because it triggers updates to a SQLite database via room. That way, future playback events can start from the correct position. These listeners are completely independent, which keeps the code much cleaner. On top of that, the playback fragment doesn't actually know anything about these listeners because they have nothing to do with the user interface. That's it for our quick look at the TV reference app. If you don't have a physical Android TV device, you can run it via the Android TV emulator. So be sure to check out the repository and let us know what you think.